not getting up. Sleeping at the shipper. I don't know about everybody else, but I don't really sleep that good. Sleep at a customer or a shipper or something, whatever. But it's about 5 o'clock now. We showed up here about 5 o'clock yesterday. It's supposed to be a simple drop and hook. And then they said they didn't have all the product for a load. Sorry, just getting up here. They didn't have all the product for the load, so the load had to be rescheduled. So I tried to get them to reschedule or take me off it, and they wouldn't take me off, and going back and forth, and about almost four hours later, because I kept going back in the office and everything. Finally, they're gonna put me in a door. Man, they're gonna put me in a door. So I told them, I hope you guys good with me staying here since you guys messed up. And they didn't really argue about that. So I said, drop in door, whatever. And park around the side of the building, and there'll be other bobtails there. So that's not a good sign. So it happens a lot. So he basically told me, come back before 6 o'clock, get your bills, get on down the road. So we're gonna walk up there, and hopefully this thing's ready to go. So let's go check her out. Check out the office. Drove by where I dropped the trailer last night.
It's not there.
So hopefully it's a good sign. Hopefully it's in the spot somewhere. Starting to rain. Golly, man. Alright. What do we got? 43,000. Come on, man. Make me wait this long and give me a heavy load. Alright. They said they parked it up here on top of the hill somewhere, so we gotta go find this thing now. Trailer, we're back loaded, ready to get out of here. We got about 4 hours to South Carolina. And, probably gonna hit just a little bit of morning traffic here in Atlanta. Hopefully it won't be that bad. So it's still like a little bit before 6 o'clock, so hopefully we can catch it all right. But we still have to get out of Atlanta, get weighed, get just a little bit of fuel for the trip. And go make our delivery. So about 230 miles. So this trip was actually supposed to be delivered yesterday because they have, once I showed up to the shipper and got, I was supposed to get picked up, I would have plenty of time to get delivered. So. But oh well, this is what happens. So hopefully today we're gonna have a better day. Yesterday wasn't that good. I mean, yesterday was a good day, but miles wise, it wasn't that good. So let's get out of here, get this thing, let's get weighed, get a little bit of fuel, get this thing delivered. All right, I'll talk to you guys just a little bit. All right, we're just pulling up here, the TA. $510. Whew, man, these tanks were empty, man. Empty.
You have 5 hours and 13 minutes of remaining drive time.
We end up getting, 510 in diesel, and 1820 in some DEF.
You have 5 hours and 13 minutes of remaining drive time.
Let's go over here
time.
And park so we can go inside for a minute. Dedicated fleet here. So I just went and checked in with them and said, hey, I need me an empty. They said, why don't you just take a load? And I said, hey, I'll take one. They said I gotta go over here to, you know, somewhere else and pick up. So they had to see if they can release an empty trailer to me. So I told them I gotta go drop my trailer and I'll come back. So they said about 15-20 minutes. So it's been about that. So we're gonna go find out and see if they can grab, let us take an empty, because they not empty, sir. But it wouldn't put it past me. Yeah. It wouldn't surprise me if they say, oh, sorry, you can't have one. See what happens. All right. So they finally released a trailer to us. We got down here to Dillon, South Carolina. We got loaded up. Now we're off to, I think it was, what was it? Newberry. Newberry, South Carolina. About 2.5 hours or so. We'll call it a day there. Get a shower, get something to eat. Do it all over again. Looks like we got to get to Indianapolis tomorrow. So once we get over to Newberry, we'll let you know what's going on with this little. Talk to you a little bit. For a delivery, the old drop and hook two times, so we gotta probably take this trailer out of the way. Just trying to figure out where to put it. I think I'll just take this trailer I got and drop it around the corner over here somewhere out of the way. What's up, buddy?
How you doing?
All right.
Been waiting on you.
I know. I told him I wasn't gonna get here till like 6. Okay. Is it a problem?
Oh no.
Okay, cool.
That's fine. All right. Normally we get it like the morning of the day before we unload it.
I gotcha.
And I wasn't here yet, so I started to worry.
Oh, nice. Okay. All right.
All right. I'll get this one out of the lock for you.
I guess would they just park this one around the corner then?
Yeah. Or you can.
I don't know. I don't know how they. I don't know how they do it. Do they just? You want this trailer where this one's at?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
But this new trailer, I want it angled more, so it's more pointing towards the door. So, instead of pointing out like this way, it's
going to be. Okay. That's no problem.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I bring it in, you just let me know where, and we'll figure it out. Let me drop this first trailer. All right. Drop this one and back up to that one over there. Up to our other trailer. We're good. paperwork signed. We'll get out of here. Talk to you guys in a minute. Alright, man. All of a sudden it got a little chilly out here. Just came over here to see what's going on. Check this out. So this is where we're at. So looks like I gotta pull forward back down there. I'm back right down in here. You got problems. So we just gotta pull all the way up there and get straight. Ain't too bad. Plenty of room. We deliver to some of these little Harbor Freight stores. It's a little tight. A little tight. This one was good, right? He actually gave me props. He said this is the quickest someone dropped a trailer in since he can remember. So, quick and efficient. Let's get out of here.